The dojo. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hello, hello.
We back right here, you know what I'm saying? Yo, the dojo, you in the place right now if you want that hip-hop shit. Yo, we are back, yo. We were off last week, you know. We're doing our usual training, you know. You know, saving the world, eradicating, you know, that whack shit off the radio. So we back now, you know, with an update. We got a crazy good show today, you know what I'm saying? Yo, Scotty Va, how you doing right now?
What's up? I'm good, man. How you doing?
Chilling, chilling, yo. We got a crazy show today, right?
Yeah, man. It's been a wild couple weeks, you know. Little break last night. Last week was actually kind of nice.
Hell yeah. We revitalized. We fresh right now, yo. We got the American Dream right now, yo. He's our honorary special co-host right now, you know, holding it down from overseas. Yo,
yeah,
say what up?
Hey, it's the kid, Big Johnson. I'm back.
Yeah, son. Yo, shout out your fans out there all over the globe.
Hey, shout out to everybody out there. It's everybody's favorite role model, GameGames.com.
Hell yeah.
Let's do it.
Hell yeah, son. Yo, we got a crazy show today because, you know, you should already know that we shouted it out a couple weeks ago. We got that battle today, so none other than P. Bills is fucking on the couch right now. Say what's good.
Yo, what's good, everybody?
Yo, who you brought today?
Brought my homeboy with it. He the host. He the one who put it all together, bar for bar, 914.
Oh, shit. He's a man in charge of tonight. That's what's good. Yo, it's just going to be lit, you know what I'm saying, from what you guys been talking about it. Yo, I'm excited. I know we're all going to be there. The dojo's going to represent over there. American Dream's going to fucking hold it down. So what can we expect tonight, you know what I'm saying? You want to talk about it?
Tell us what's going on tonight.
Oh, you got your mic on? Turn your mic on. All right.
Yeah, I think it's on.
There you go.
You got three good battles. We got first battle start at 8 o'clock. It's going to be Bridge Belvedere versus Pro from Greenberg.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. Our second one. Got my man P. Bills.
P. Bills in the building.
Versus Nino from Looney Gang. And then our main event is Bags the Rider versus Peso.
Oh, shit. So it's going to be lit tonight. How you think the turnout's going to be?
I'm pushing for 100, 200 the crowd.
Damn.
That's what I'm pushing for right now.
Wear it up.
Have you put these on in the past, like battle events in the past? Or
nah, this is my first event.
Yeah.
I had this idea about 2 years ago, and I'm just now putting it together.
How did you get into it? Like, how did you put it all together?
I'm doing everything by myself. So I started it. I used to just grow up watching Smack.
Hell yeah.
Just left from there. I'm following his format. I think it's his format.
Can't go wrong with that.
So does your league have a name yet, or is it just
no?
Just
right now it's just Bar for Bar 914 for the moment.
All
right. It should change as the next event.
That's what's up, because you know.
All right. So that's the title of the actual event.
Yeah.
All right.
It's going to be a crazy show because we got American Dream. He's a huge battle rap fan, and, you know, he's going to be at the show tonight, like I said. And so it's going to be a crazy discussion. We got some discussion battle rap topics today, you know what I'm saying? But actually, fans should recognize American Dream. You know, he called in mad times in the past, holding it down overseas. But we're going to fucking get into this shit. So let's just talk about, you know, battle rap today. Because American Dream, this first time you're here, why don't you talk about your favorite artists, you know, live and, you know, basically about the battle rap, who you think's going to fucking... Went about the cannabis and actually not cannabis, Cassidy and Disaster. Let's
you
talk
know,
about this
for
shit
me,
real quick.
I feel like it's really based off the circuit you're on. So if you're on Smack, you're gonna be talking about guns.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll kill you. I'll chop you up. Whatever. If you're on Grind Time, it's a lot of jokes. Being that they're battling, it looks like it's gonna be a form of Grind Time / King of the Dot.
Since
this is like Lush One's new league.
Uh-huh.
I'm a roll. I honestly think Disaster's gonna get it over Cassidy. You know, for one, he's got more to talk about.
Uh-huh. You know?
And, I mean, I don't know. I think that's my opinion.
P-Bills, you know? What do you think about that?
Like, if... Oh, hold on.
Oh, go ahead.
Now,
go.
If they battled on Smack,
uh-huh.
I think the crowd's going to lean more towards Cassidy. Now, and then, like we were talking about earlier, is it based off crowd reaction or is it based off bars?
Yeah.
You know? Like Mook and Iron Solomon, we don't know who really won because we didn't really get to hear what Iron had to say. You can't just go back and watch the battle without seeing it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, oh, P-Bills like, got something to say.
Go ahead.
Yo, P-Bills is battling tonight. What we got to say about that?
Because this is killing me right now. He said Sirius Jones beat Mook.
He did.
He's still on it. Mook had the better boss. I don't judge battles off crowd reaction. I listen to bars.
Uh-huh.
Mook definitely had the better boss. Sometimes Sirius Jones was... freestyling a bunch of gibberish.
Oh,
he really he lost that against Boop. reason.
I honestly believe like a lot of the stuff Mook said was just filler, and it was a lot of nonsense.
So what did Sirius? All right, so since you think Sirius Jones won, what did Sirius Jones really say that was so tough?
He had a lot of good references. The one where he was like, you know, Rock beat up Beef like Rocky in the meat freezer. I haven't watched this in years. So
That was so simple. So that was better than the dot joint that Mook did at the end.
But I mean,
that was way better.
If the crowd didn't do that, do you believe everyone would have went crazy back home?
Mook has performance, so we know how Dot Mob is. Sirius Jones came to that battle by himself, first off. But actually, he shouldn't have been by himself because he said he know wild people in Harlem.
Yeah, that's the thing. And that's why, like, Sirius Jones and Math. When Math did that, in my opinion, he saw what he was up against. You know, I mean, you know, he knew it was going to be a long night, just like when he battled Calico and his feelings got hurt. So that was his way out of being embarrassed that night.
Sirius Jones didn't even rap yet.
That was his first round.
Sirius Jones did rap?
Yeah, and then when Matt started rhyming, he had those girls up there who were half naked dancing. They didn't have no top on. They had the paint. They were dancing while Matt was battling, so no one was listening.
That's another thing that messed up battle rap. Battle rap is about bars. Come to a battle to see females twerking.
Yeah, exactly.
But, yeah. I mean,
you got to get the criteria right. You know what I'm saying?
I heard that at the Hollow and Joe Budden's battle, Hollow planted part of the crowd to Boo Buttons when he rapped.
Oh, wow.
See, that's sucker status. Like, if that's true, that's
allegedly.
So you think there should be no type of props in battles? Like,
I'm saying,
it's a competition, you know? You got to be straightforward.
You could pull up props and all that in battles, but Math, I guess Math was just on some other shit that day. He was wrong for snuffing Sirius Jones.
Got the best one. So. We battled DNA, Professor Sean.
Yeah.
That's what's up, yo. We're getting ready for the battle, you know what I'm saying? We got all this battle pre-discussion, but I'm more interested because we've been talking about this. Cassidy versus Aster, yo. Honestly, to me, Cassidy got this, so I want to hear what you guys have to say. I want to have the final discussion today, you know what I'm saying? Just see who, actually predictions to see who the fuck's going to win. And, you know, we can make predictions, and once it finally comes down, we could talk about it once it goes down. But what do you guys say? If you guys had to pick it right now, make some predictions for Cassidy or in Disaster.
I'm going with Cass.
Yeah, I have a hard time believing it's going to be the final discussion.
Everybody knows Cassidy's life, what Cassidy's been through, so by Disaster brings that up, it's not really going to move the crowd to me.
Yeah.
We already know what Cassidy's been through. So
yeah, yeah.
To me, that wasn't really...
Like what Cassidy was saying, like, how are you going to get at me? Like, I'm that nigga, so, like, what are you possibly going to say? But I know American Dream has, you know, of course,
his
ideas.
I got Disaster 2-1. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? Like, I like Cass, and I don't think anyone in hip-hop can punch like Cass does.
Uh-huh.
You know, nobody can punch like Cass. And, you know, when it comes to freestyles and mixtapes, no one's messing with him. All
right, so there's your reason right there.
I think my man Banks is still up there. My man Lloyd Banks is up there.
But this is a battle, though. This is about...
Punch with Cass. I'm talking about punchlines. Lloyd Banks can punch with Cassidy.
Yeah, but it's more of like on tracks, and like it's not the conviction's not there, like the intensity Cassidy puts on the track or when he battles is not there. Like,
when's the last time that Cassidy got like a battle that was like a big that we all know?
Only one I know.
Well, that's the thing. Why do you got to know it?
Exactly. So here we go. One battle against somebody who's not known for battling. You beat
that's
down
one
on
one battle that has been caught on camera before all this YouTube sensation shit.
So Cassidy's worth $250,000.
Off his name, that's what they offer him, so he accepted it. What's wrong
but
with that?
According to him, that's according to Cassidy, though, because Disaster's saying he didn't get that much.
I mean, shows up on a hologram.
Even, you know.
Can't hit on the hologram. That shit was popping.
It's fucking awesome, but it's, you know.
Cass is that dude. Don't get me wrong.
Thank you.
I'm not knocking him. He's a better lyricist than Disaster, but when it comes to battling and it's
I wouldn't
about
say
being,
that. Why would you,
you
say
know,
that?
Getting at each other. And no, he's got more to talk about.
He's
and
like
he's
Eminem
good at
on crack.
It, and he's been doing it
me,
all this time.
To me, I think he was scared of Murder Mook, though.
Cass?
Yeah, that's why he kept upping the price. Like, I need a certain amount of money.
See, Mook is out there. Mook has done it 1,000 times. You
Mook,
know,
is,
like,
Mook is a battle rap legend.
Yeah.
Well, but people say the same thing about Mook that they're trying to say about Cassidy. Like, Mook disappeared for a long time. Like, Cassidy pretty much did the same shit.
You got to do that, though, to demand a certain amount. Like, Floyd Mayweather will fight back in the day once a year.
Yeah.
Get $30 million paydays. You making the crowd want you more, you know what I mean? If you fought every month, like those guys, back in the day, Sugar Ray Robinson, ain't no one going to show up to your battle. You battle twice a year. Oh, I'm going. You know, and you promote it the right way. That's how you make that money. Because you notice all these other guys wasn't getting 10, 20,000.
Yeah.
But because, you know, but they, you know, they built their brand and then they say, all right, I'm holding out until I get what I want. And then that Summer Madness 2, when they all came back getting 10 apiece, and Mook got 20 because he didn't battle for years, but he built the brand up, and then he made y'all want that brand.
I feel like Loaded Lux deserved more than Mook, though. He had a better performance than everything.
You talking about Total night? Slaughter?
At the last
I'm not talking
round.
About Total Slaughter. I'm talking about Summer Madness too.
Oh, okay.
Lux should have got 20,000 too.
Yeah.
Well, that's how it is. You know what I'm saying? A lot of corruption.
I think Calico's spit is, you know, he spit some good shit, but it just wasn't in comparison to what Lux said.
But he was losing. Lux was killing that.
But it was also, you also got to understand, we're looking at it in retrospect. After the performance, Lux should probably get it because of the theatrics. Going into it, people wasn't necessarily really looking for Lux as much as they were Mook.
Well, Lux beat Mook in the past, so why doesn't Lux deserve 20K?
Because Mook battled Sirius, Mook battled Jay Mills. Jay Mills' battle was real memorable.
Yeah.
Mook lost to Jay Mills.
But regardless of whether you won or lost, the Dot Mob, the whole Dot Mob thing, is a collective to be fucked with. not saying like lyrically. Well, I'm just saying
like
that
lyric wise.
I'm not talking. Yeah, but you see what's from a business standpoint, the dots are movement. So
P Bills, who you got for Disastrous versus Cassidy? Honestly,
who I got?
Yeah,
I'm just watching this. Oh, I'm just saying this. Cassidy just better win. I need a clear win for Cassidy. Yeah.
Scott, I see that episode.
He say he the king of battle rap and all this other crazy shit and all this other crazy talk. You better win.
Why is that so crazy, though? Why is that so hard to believe? You look at the, you know, population of battle rappers, the majority of them have Cassidy style.
Because he only beat Freeway. Freeway don't even do
He didn't only beat Freeway. You have footage that specifically says from like Swiss Beats and other notable people saying that he actually.
Because it's not on YouTube. It's being recorded, though. That's just how it is.
Nah.
Tyson could have knocked out a bunch of people, but we only care about what we saw.
Nah, obviously it's all about perception, but what really went down.
Cassidy ain't beat up on a bunch of nobody.
Yeah, like how do we know? I could go around saying I beat everybody that you never heard of.
It's true. Joe Budden did say the same thing. He had previous battles, and no one believed him, and it turned out he, you know, his performance wasn't
that's like,
you know, all
that's
that.
Like,
but
that's
Cassidy,
like a weed man come on your block, right? You're talking about he got that fire. Yeah. You're not gonna believe him until you smoke it, right?
Exactly.
But hold on.
So you need,
if you're smart,
you need to see what's up.
As far as Joe Budden goes, though, like the Total Slaughter event. It could have been better. I think it would have been better on Smack. You should have the crowd. You should have your entourage on stage with you.
It was their first time. They had sound issues. We talked about this before. I mean,
yeah. I honestly think if it was on Smack, like Loaded Lux versus Hollow, that battle could have been better if it was on Smack. It would have been, well, you know, like UW is not a big name like Smack, you know? Even though Total Slaughter is a bigger name than Smack, they're not developed yet. They're not established.
Yeah.
And so I don't think it worked out that well. If they had their entourage on stage, you would have felt it more.
They should have let Smack host it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, they had Sway up there, who's pretty corny. You know?
Come on, no.
Total Slaughter was cool, but like, I spent $170 for that ticket.
VIP all day.
Yeah, I mean, we got to go backstage and meet people and stuff like that, but like, the event itself, it was like real gimmicky. You know,
well, what do you expect from Eminem's brand? You know what I'm saying? That's what he's all about.
I think we would have got backstage anyway.
Nah. Well, we were supposed to do. We paid mad money. We were supposed to get a meet and greet. We're supposed to get fucking like a prize package, something. We didn't get none of that.
Food.
The only reason
we were
backstage is because we were fucking with Lux's groupie. She snuck us backstage and fucking we were chilling with Loaded Lux while watching the Joe Budden battle. But
yeah,
that battle, I think it was too big. Like, a lot of the battle rappers just couldn't exist and fucking, you know, maintain on that big stage. Like,
especially what
their
Daylight
styles.
Did.
Yeah. Daylight's, know. Like, his metaphors and stuff are way too complex for a big-ass crowd to understand. Like,
but Daylight did what he did because they wouldn't let his mans in to come in. So
you talked about that.
So Daylight was just like, fuck this whole shit, I'm going to do what I want to do, and he just shitted on everybody.
But then that makes people not want to watch that anymore.
Right, but Daylight is a crazy dude. So whatever he do is, it's just helping his stock rise. Like, he just gonna do whatever to keep people.
There's a lot of really mad people at that show, like in the crowd.
It could have been better on Smack, in my opinion. You know, like.
Yo, we rocking with P Bills right now. The dojo. We got American Dream in the building. You know, it's me, Sir Spitz, holding it down as always. Got Scotty Vile in the building. You know what I'm saying? Yo, we're about to take a quick commercial break, real quick. We'll be right back and fucking keep talking about this battle shit. You know what I'm saying? Cause we got a crazy event tonight, yo. Yo, be right back, son.
Monday's got you off the wagon?
Well, worry no more, because it's now officially a part of the three-day weekend. So get on board. Come party with the Standby Gypsy, Juju the Model, and Blue Rivera every Monday night for your Entertainment Week in Review, off-the-wall interactive segments, live performances, in-depth interviews, and the latest in sports. The Hangover Takeover is live every Monday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on ZenLive.tv.
Yo. We are back, you know what I'm saying? Yo, let's throw... We're talking about battle rap right now, you know what I'm saying? Because we got a crazy event right now, tonight scheduled, you know what I'm saying? We're all going to be there fucking holding it down. Yonkers represent all day. But talking about that, you know, Cassidy disaster shit. Honestly, I think Cassidy got it. Wait, Scotty, who'd you say you got for this again?
Oh, I didn't.
Oh, who, yeah, tell me about it. I want to hear who you got to say about that. Because I got some footage I want to put up real quick to doubt, you know, shut up any doubters out there. So
yeah, so I don't know. Cassidy charged $250,000.
They offer him $250,000. Okay.
They're giving him that much in the battle. He shows up on a hologram.
No, actually, it wasn't Cassidy who showed up on a hologram. That dude, the guy behind it all, that new circuit.
Yeah.
He's like a billionaire, that British dude. Yeah. If you watch the press conference.
I didn't.
He hooked that shit up. But yo, let's go to the video real quick. Let's play the first video for the doubters out there.
What are we playing?
I gotta show you guys something real quick. You know, if you watch the press conference.
How you gonna say it's for the culture when you went and did it for the money? I respect the businessman thing. I'm not saying not to get your money. I'm just saying don't say I'm doing it for the culture. You can't say that because you would have did it for free, Dad.
First of all, don't no PR tell me what to say. I ain't making shit up, so I know exactly what I said. And I didn't say this battle was for the culture. I said it's gonna help the culture. That's two different things. I'm not battling just for the culture because I already helped the culture enough. But this battle is definitely going to help the culture because more niggas going to be tuned in than they ever was. More stars, more big niggas, more niggas that never even gave a fuck about battle rap is going to be tuned in. You want to know why? Not because disaster a part of it, but because Cassidy is. So it's going to help the fucking culture if anybody got any common sense. But I'm not doing it for the culture. I don't just go out and go on the corner and rap in ciphers for the culture. Nah, this is a business now. So niggas gotta pay me. But at the end of the day, it's gonna help the culture way more than any of these battle niggas can help the culture. Y'all need help. That's why y'all reaching out to niggas that's on. It's just that the niggas that was on so far ain't show up. So y'all like, damn, we need somebody to show up. And y'all found one. So now I'ma really help it and I'ma really show up. It's gonna be like the best of both worlds. So don't put words in my mouth saying I'm doing it for the culture. That's what you do it for. A nigga that don't really make no money off it, it gotta be for the culture. It gotta be for something. But for me, it's for the fucking chicken. But it's gonna help the culture.
I hate that term. I can't lie.
It's better than guap, first of all. But
the chicken?
The chicken.
But come on, yo.
He kept it real. He kept it 100.
If you haven't seen the press conference, I feel like it revealed a lot. I feel like it revealed how the battle's going to go, just the intensity that Cassidy's going to
come. I have an idea now.
Chicken.
All right, like, he's really serious. Like, he's really going to go in. Like, he's not playing around. Like, Disaster, if he wants to come with that shit where, should I say he's not really that dude? Look at him. He is that dude. Like, he's not playing around, yo. Like, he's really going to bring that shit. Like, it's not.
Well, look, I agree with P. Bills, man. Like, look, if you're talking all that, I'm going to just shut up and, like, all right, and watch you work.
You
better do your thing. Don't go out there half-stepping because you hyped yourself up enough, you know? You ever play a ball with somebody who's saying they're that great? And you just give them the ball. Like, all right, do your thing. I'll move out your way.
It's 1,000 layups straight. And you just
yep. Yo, when they're trash, you don't want to fight them? So. I want to fight them. When they're trash, I want to fight them, man.
That's true.
And I ain't even that nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, yeah.
It's like making you work harder now because, but no, I mean, if it's for the chicken, you know, the chicken. Like, I think that's the dumbest term ever. Like, we're reaching nowadays, you know.
Yo, sometimes that chicken is worth more than it's fucking advertised, you know.
Yeah.
But come on, yo. Like, I feel like that's just, it's really going to be Cassidy just, Disaster's going to come with the same shit. It's going to be, it's a style mismatch. I guess that's the main point.
People do a lot for chicken.
Sir Spitz.
Yes.
Do you think Disaster beat Math, and not physically? We all know that's true, but I mean verbally.
I saw the third round, and I feel like Math was going in. To me, I just watched Disaster do the same thing every time.
Math 1.
You think I got so? It. T-P-Bells, I got,
I got, I got Math 2, one of the, or debatable 3-0.
What?
In that battle.
I just disaster, don't like that. I guess that's what but it
after,
is.
But let's stick to one topic with the Cassidy shit. After that video, how do you, is that, did that change your mind about Cassidy? Who, for those who haven't seen it, like, what do you think about it? Like, how intense he's going in? I didn't think he was gonna be that intense about it.
He's a rapper. He can act. He's putting on a show. Wow. He's selling the fight. I mean, he's just selling the fight.
He took it more personal. The way he was yelling.
You guys had him sounding like angry. A cartoon character to me. You put the video on, I get to understand
Cassidy
where he's coming
has
from.
No choice but to come with it. He's been talking crazy. You the king, so prove to me you the king.
Definitely. All right, let's throw that second video on just to further prove the point. This is a quick short video real quick for anyone who's still down, the Cassidy fans out there, because, all right, it's going to explain a lot. This dude said a lot of valid points.
It's all right, man. Now, first off, this is not a blog. You know what I'm saying? This is just real fucking talk. No diss to Disaster, because he's been in my top five for a few years now. You know what I'm saying? He lost to Pat Stay, Daylight, and then Math Hoffa back to back to back. He's still somewhere in my top 10. Cassidy ain't no fucking slouch. He's not Joe Budden with an imaginary battle career that nobody can vouch for. And he's definitely not cannabis. The man has battled probably half of your favorite industry artists today back in the early 2000s. Swizz Beatz, people from Rough Riders have vouched.
I had heard that there's a bunch of Cassidy battles that are not the freeway battle. There's other shit out there.
Cassidy got a lot of shit out there. He battled so many people, man. I don't think you understand. Like, battling was like a tour.
Some of your favorite URL battlers too. Goods, for instance. He'll talk about battling Cassidy, but he won't ever talk about who won. And there's a reason for that. Why the fuck is this even going down right now? It's probably the worst style clash in battle rap history. If you had to define Cassidy in battle rap today, he would be a gun bar battle rapper.
Hey, does I clap you up? Cassidy, put your stomach on the ground like bad push-ups. I get mashed up, get a Glock in 240s, and show up to your spot like it's a costume party. I'm sorry, but I sold more crack than albums. I red dot your face like acne problems.
Let's look at Disaster's record against gun bar battle rappers. His battle with Rex?
Shit, but I'ma snap back and I'ma fucking grab fucking. Hey, fuck you! Fuck you!
Crash and burn. He even lost to Cortez, for God's sakes. You know what I mean? Like, no offense to Cortez, but at the time he was in a slump. Only reason him and Math Hoffa worked was because they had history. And he still lost. Again, not taking anything away from Diz. You know, he deserves the big battles. If Eminem came back, I'd want to see him go against Diz. But this is Cassidy we're talking about. When Disaster goes against a gun bar battle rapper, his main objective is always to stress how they're not really real and they're not really busting their guns. Like, Cassidy went to prison for manslaughter, so it's like, that's dead.
I committed multiple crimes, that's why I've been to jail multiple times.
So what's left? To out-gun bar him? We saw him try that against Rex, and it was awkward as fuck.
Even though I am the cab driver, he still couldn't see me coming. I'm coming up the block. Oh, he gonna see me gunning, which makes sense. I'm a taxi driver, because I have this Nina you've been dying to meet, and you're gonna meet her running. That was freestyle.
Ladies and
that
gentlemen, Dojo fans. Hey, yo. Dojo fans, that is exactly what's gonna happen against Cassidy.
Now,
you know
hold
saying?
On, I got something
I show
to say.
Bad highlights of Disaster. I don't show
exactly.
That's
number one.
No.
Hold on, number two. You saying?
I mean, against Cannon, like, y'all show all bad highlights of Disaster.
Check this out.
No. Bar that he just spit was hot, but it was unbelievable. That's the problem. Like, he's a great lyricist, but you gotta take it for what it is. He's not able to go out and try to speak like that.
I felt like people should have cheered that. Niggas cheered DNA when he said, "I'm a blast of machete." How you blast him? Machete.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
How you snipe with a 38 and niggas cheer for that?
I know that's so, that. I agree with that. That's different, but that's
a
different.
38 is wild small. How you sniping a nigga with that? And how do you blast a machete?
I'm not saying no. I'm by no means. I'm saying Disaster's the only one who does this.
Hey, he blast called machete, out on that yo. Too. I left the machete straight. But hey, another thing.
Yes, you, American Dream.
All right, you show nothing, but you saying that. All right, can I get my thoughts together? Okay, when he goes up against gun bar battlers. Right, But it's not about the battle. It's the circuit you're on. So if you're on Smack, that's what they want to hear. It was about the crowd reaction. It wasn't about who he was battling at the moment. They wasn't messing with him right there. They wasn't fucking with him. If he said that on King of the Dot, they may have went crazy because it's a different type of crowd. And, you know, so it's not. And then number two, the same way Cassidy.
What do you have to say about that?
Because Charlie Clips spits that, I think.
Disaster's nasty. Like he's a battle rapper. That's all he
Look,
really
the same
is.
Way they saying Cassidy's gonna kill him is the same way they say Cannabis was gonna kill Disaster.
No, it's a little different. It's
oh
different.
My god, it's the craziest
it's
thing
different.
Ever. And he went in there and got slaughtered.
I've seen Disaster absolutely destroy people. Yeah. Absolutely destroy people.
Definitely.
Cannabis is one of them. Right?
Just pulled out from
Hold
the
on.
Chat.
Was,
yeah.
This yeah. battle is big. Is big because it's Cassidy, who is a huge name, and then you got Disaster, the guy who beat Cannabis.
And then y'all say he don't do good against people with gun bars. All right, DNA has a million gun bars. Though I gave that to DNA, Disaster still put on a classic with DNA.
Yeah.
So it depends on what
it could
disaster,
be anybody.
It
could
depends
be
on
anybody.
What disaster we're getting. If we get the Disaster that goes against DNA, then it's going to be a crazy battle.
That was an ex, yeah.
If
and
we
he
get
was
that
at his,
Disaster.
He was at
see,
his
Disaster, when he tried to switch it, and try to force it instead of
so,
being himself.
Uh-huh.
That's where he fucks up at.
So why do you think he did so well in that battle as opposed to what we just saw?
Well, I think because he was being himself with that shit against Rex.
Uh-huh.
He was forcing it.
Okay.
He wasn't being himself. He's trying to force them gun lines. I think if he had just been rapping, being himself, and then throw a gun line in there, it would have came off better. But since he tried to force that line,
okay.
And then you could tell with the meter and the cab driver, running, he tried to put too much shit together.
Plus, and he didn't feel
well,
at
that's
home.
That's all
like, I saw that battle, and you could tell he didn't feel at home. His confidence level was down because he was on that platform.
Exactly.
If he was on King of the Dot, Rex, when he battled Awkwards, and I think Awkwards is okay, Awkwards won that battle, but
I don't think that.
Uh-oh. What do you got to say?
Rex, right?
Yeah. And Awkwards.
Yeah, I get that to Rex. Even though Rex had one, instead he didn't see segregation right.
Segregation, yeah.
I think it was 2-1.
American Dream, why don't you talk about your two favorite surprises? Like, you know, remember that Calico Dad shit? The fucking.
Oh, yes.
We were talking about that earlier.
Lux
two
and,
of
Lux
his.
And Hollow.
But how do we know that's really Calico's dad?
I don't think they would have lied.
I said
about
the same
that.
Thing about that. What was the other one about the dude who T-Rex supposedly
did? Y'all ever see the T-Rex and O-Red battle?
Yeah.
And the part when he was like, that's your man, you know, he was like, you try to get cool points in your last battle.
So I'm like, how do we know you really know him like that? You could pay somebody to act like you know them.
But he's got blogs. He's actually. Somebody in the world of hip hop.
I mean, the way the world is nowadays, I don't be believing a lot of shit unless I have.
I don't think.
Real
you know what?
Proof.
I don't. Nah, because the rest of the cast, before that line, I went back and watched it. Before he said, you know, you try to get cool points mentioned in Winklok, that's your man. And he was like, that's my nigga. Now he was like, Winklok, front and center. Dude was standing right there. And you could tell Arsenal just before that line, just try to play it cool because he was hoping that he would take the bait. You know?
So that basically means Rex got 4-0 then, because he already lost that battle 3-0. Then
so he was O-Red? Yeah.
He got 4-0.
O-Red is underrated, too. I don't think people give him his props.
His battle with Clips, that battle was trash, though. I'm disappointed with him and Charlie Clips.
Yeah.
I gave it to O-Red, but
I'm disappointed. Did you see Clips and X-Factor?
Yeah, I see.
Who you think won that battle, honestly?
Clips clearly took that.
You think?
X-Factor was spitting bars, but Clips, the way he presented it and came off, and then he
I
put
think
that disrespect
Clips had better
in there.
I think Clips had good bars, but no, I think Clips won. But I think X Factor's performance and he said some hot lines that people just didn't get. Yeah. You know,
just X Factor, he wasn't comfortable, like, because Clips basically stole it from him. He just felt like, all right, I'm already uncomfortable, and then Clips got the crowd against me.
And that's
so he didn't keep his confidence up, so he just let his confidence just go down, and then made him look even badder than he already did. But he was definitely spitting.
Well, that's
he just
how it is.
Added some confidence behind himself.
Yo, it's the dojo, you know. We're about to take a real quick break. We're here with fucking With It. We got Pete Bills. We got American Dream in the building. Scotty Valio. We'll be right back, and we'll go on to some freestyle shit. We'll talk more about the battle shit real quick, though. We'll be right back.
Monday's got you off the wagon? Well, worry no more, because it's now officially a part of the three-day weekend. So get on board. Come party with the Standby Gypsy, Juju the Model, and Blue Rivera every Monday night for your entertainment week in review, off-the-wall interactive segments, live performances, in-depth interviews, and the latest in sports. The Hangover Takeover is live every Monday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on zenlive.tv.
How do you always use that word so much.
I say 100 times every morning. Keeps my teeth white. And one more thing. Where the fuck did you get that accent?
Hey, this is Vinny Pastore. You call me Big Pussy, and you're watching ZenLive.tv.
You're watching the Zedalza Entertainment Network on ZenLive.tv. Here, you'll find ridiculously good-looking people, equipped with knowledge, intellect, and passion for speaking the truth. Does it get any sexier? A filtered mind is the only crime for ZenLive. Stay tuned.
Are you a smoker and you need to quit? But you're the scariest guy that's out of this and like doing me.
Plains Vapors, located at 210 Amerenick Avenue in White Plains, New York. Visit our location and choose from a wide selection of exotic flavors.
Entertainment Network on ZenLive.tv.
Yo, 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 we are back, you know what I'm saying? Sir Spitz, yo, we got Scotty Vile as always. Yo, we are fucking joined by P Bills. We got Witty in the building, you know, the host of tonight's event. You know, we're going to be out there. Shit's going to be popping off. We got our man American Dream right now over from overseas, from the Middle East, holding it down. We got embassies all over, you know what I'm saying? But, yo, let's get into this shit. What's going on tonight? Yo, I want to hear more about what's going on tonight. Talk about it, you know, see what we got to expect. And I know American Dream has some questions about it since, you know, he's a huge battle rap fan.
Yeah, well, tonight's going to be at in Yonkers, New York. First battle start at 8 p.m. sharp. Closed doors at 7:45.
Yeah, yeah.
We also got a couple, you know, artists to perform there.
So how'd you find the talent for tonight? And I know you got performances too as well, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah. The address also is 508 Nepean Avenue, Yonkers.
Be there, Dojo fans. We'll be there. So P Bills, like, how have you been preparing for this battle? You excited? You ready?
I didn't prepare.
Oh, you didn't, right?
I'm freestyling everything.
You freestyling like disaster?
Yeah, I'm just coming in saying a bunch of gibberish. I'm gonna say I got a gun so big you can show money dance in it.
Damn, yo, it's gonna be like that.
Yeah.
Yo, yeah. So
now, do you got a history with this cat you battling or?
Yeah.
Nah, no history.
Okay.
I was gonna come to the battle in a Squidward costume. You
know, like Scuba Steve.
Squidward.
Yeah. Yeah, like at first when I started it, not too many rappers really wanted to mess with the battle joint.
Cause them niggas in Yonkers are scared, talk all that shit, never want to battle somebody face to face.
Damn.
So then a couple dudes hit me up that been battling before, said, yo, we'll help you start it. So
nice.
They linked me up with everybody, and P Bills, he's been promoting hard.
Word up. Yeah, I seen it all over Facebook and everything.
Gotta promote yourself. Ain't nobody else gonna do it for you.
Hell yeah. I even saw that diss track you put out. So what was that about? You wanna talk about that?
Oh, that was just throwing shots at my competition. That's all it was.
Ah, you're getting ready. I like it.
I mean, he still say I suck, but
you're warming up. You know
he
what
gotta
saying?
Prove that to me today. Like, he gotta beat me. Like,
yeah, cause they talking about they not writing or nothing. Like, they just gonna come in there.
Wow.
They gonna embarrass themselves.
See, I'm gonna keep it 100. I actually, bro, I'm prepared.
Nah, you're on the dojo. I don't expect anything less.
A performance, you know what I mean?
Like, they talking about, oh, we not writing. And they hit me up today, yo, we didn't write nothing, but we still coming. Like, all
right, you know, see, that's what Yonkers niggas do. See, I can see now when I win, right?
Uh-huh.
It's gonna be 1,000 excuses. Oh, I didn't write. Uh-huh. I didn't take him serious. I don't care about this battle shit. Yeah. I had 4 shows today. Blah, blah, blah. But nigga, you still in the hood, nigga. Like, fuck out of here. You don't get that bullshit.
Yeah. Well, nigga,
take your L like a man and be quiet. Next battle.
If you guys are given that much time, you should try. At least to write a little bit. You know?
I mean, you know, if a mainstream battle rapper did that and they didn't show up, they would be getting all kinds of criticism. You know what I mean? So why?
And that's that psychological warfare. They telling you, yo, we not writing.
Mm-hmm.
But they be writing.
Yeah, they trying to get mercy. You know, yeah, like, oh, okay. Go easy on me. Don't go for the knockout.
To me, I think they're going to lose if they didn't write and be prepared. That's how I look at it.
Yeah. There's no point. Why would they risk that? You know what I'm saying? They better be prepared.
Plus, they got a big name in Yonkers because they're called Looney Gang. So
I'm going to treat this battle how life treat me. See, I have a disability. Life don't go easy on me. Uh-huh. So if you coming in there with nothing, why should I go easy on you? I'm not going to show you no mercy. I'm going to teach you a lesson.
But definitely, you got a fly-ass fucking haircut. Talk about it.
Yo, JoJo fans, call in right now if you want to talk about this man's haircut. I got to show that. Yo, show the camera right there. Yo, we ready for tonight, you know what I'm saying? We all the way turned up for tonight.
You know, I joined the Illuminati. That's why I got this
haircut. It's like
this
some Mayan shit.
I had a talk. I decided to get on my Blade Wesley shit, you feel me? The sacrificial lamb for tonight is the person I'm battling. Damn. So, you know, to join the Illuminati, you got to sacrifice somebody.
He about to bring that holy water out.
I got to sacrifice my opponent.
Talk about it.
He's like a Mayan spaceman.
You guys are amping it up, yo. This shit's going to be lit tonight, I can tell, yo. I'm very anticipating this shit.
Where's it going to be?
Yonkers, New York. 508.
Shout out Yonkers.
Definitely check that out. Yeah,
508, Nepean Avenue, Yonkers, New York.
We in there, you know what I'm saying? Representing, you know, real hip hop, you know? Hip hop encompasses everything. We got that battle art as well, you know what I'm saying?
Real quick, tickets. Can people still get tickets?
Yeah. Just hit me up. I think after 7 o'clock, I'm not really gonna be able to handle the tickets.
Yo, we got those tickets.
They gotta pay $20 at the door.
Yeah, $10 a ticket, $20 at the door. I don't control the door. I just control the tickets.
So if you watching or listening right now, call in 914-595-4871. It's the Dojo. They got the tickets to the battle tonight. If you really want to,
you already know.
You want to really fucking check it out? Like, you don't even gotta wait till after they get off. Call us up right now.
Yep. You already know that shit, you know what I'm saying?
These are the people that are, you know, in control right now.
Hell yeah. We fucking about to do the damn thing. But yo, American Dream, you got any further questions? I know how much, you know, you're fucking into battle.
This is my first battle, so that, you know, I'm already excited, you know what I mean? I didn't get to go to Total Slaughter with you boys you know what I mean? So
it's definitely
my first battle.
It's my first event too. I ain't never been to a battle before.
Oh yeah,
it's hosting.
I've heard about battles like local,
bold move,
like Yonkers battles. I've never been, but I've seen footage actually, like
a couple of these Getty guys. Square. I forgot what they used to call it, something different. Where they guys used to meet up.
The YMCA in the basement.
Yeah, and then they used to battle in Hip Hop Jeans over there on Palisades. They used to go in there and battle too. Yeah.
I seen some guys down there. I know Doc was like judging one of them events. One of our friends.
From 3G, right?
Yeah, I seen him.
3G represent.
I seen him in the background in one of the videos.
That Young Yonkers and Young Knockout battle.
Yeah, that was a good battle. Yeah, destroyed.
So after this battle today, are you gonna continue to do more battles every quarter? You gonna throw a battle?
People see me really put it together and stuff, and I started getting a lot of hit ups.
So anybody, any investors yet? Like, are you trying to go?
Trying to see after this what I can get and what help.
Alright. Yeah.
Yo, we rocking it here with Dojo, with P Bills right now. Yo, I wanna hear a little taste of what's to come for tonight for the Dojo fans, so I want you guys out there. So why don't we just throw a beat on real quick and let's get into it. I know it's about that time.
Oh yeah. This ain't really
good.
Turn this beat.
This
is
some
Thomas
Cypher. I like the beat, but it's not a cypher beat. Turn that. Yeah, I need some cypher type shit, man.
I'm just gonna throw some shit on while I get my life together.
I know you know some cypher type beats.
Yo, we got P Bills in the building.
Yo, we gonna fuck with this.
Yo, it's gonna be lit tonight when he goes into the battlefield.
Fucking with this beat right here?
Nah, he don't want this. Give him what you want, Shook Ones.
Yo, this is the man of the hour tonight. He's mentally prepared.
Shook Ones is like,
you know what we gotta get on? Lose yourself. We gotta get that 8 Mile shit going.
I'm fucking playing right.
Shook Ones. Knees weak, arms are sweaty. Oh shit. This is triumph
for that reason. Put Shook Ones on, man.
Damn,
Shook Ones is like the standard for
Shook
just freestyling. Yeah. That's like one of the dopest beats to freestyle on. Yeah.
It's up to P Bills.
I can't rap, but I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
I'm not going to be the only one in
how
the
about,
room.
How about
Sir Spitz is spitting too?
Yeah,
Scotty spitting, so we can need a cypher beat.
Yeah. Let's throw something on. We can all vibe too and fucking go in. But I definitely want to hear some. Let's do the damn thing.
Play Alchemist, yeah.
Yo, let's put this beat. How could you go wrong? How could you go wrong?
Exactly. How can you go wrong with this?
This is like this is the standard for freestyling, in my opinion. Like, you can't go wrong with this beat.
All right.
What, y'all want me to set? Y'all want me to set off, or one of y'all go?
Yo, who wants? Yo, Scotty, go first. You never go first.
Me? Yeah. This is some old school sounding shit.
Yeah, we were just knocking their new album today. Shout out to Mobb Deep.
Yeah. Scotty Vicious, naughty with the missus, kicking boxes full of jizz, then open up them shits till Christmas.
Oh.
Malicious, the way I'm hitting, man, I'm spitting mine. Dirty dishes, non-chewed food that's hardly bitten rhymes. Splitting minds, ripping spines, cause I'm boxed again, lost again. Lots of nicotine between the oxygen, knocking in.
Woo.
Rock and rolling, flowing, no regrets. Broken necks, I'm choking, blessed. My mind's an open Rolodex, groping breasts. Breast the best, left them like a smoking bong. He wrote me wrong, so goes the song. I promise y'all a broken thong. All hope is gone with the ocean chosen, pass it on. Told his mom, bold him cold like a frozen mass. Past is gone, the future's new and infinite. That's if you into it. V, I keep it cool like Winamit. My mouth's an instrument, a rock, a toxin like Calarius. Vicariously vary, I guess I'm just a rare Aquarius.
Woo! Scotty, Vile. Yo, Vile.
It's getting hot in here now.
Yo, you turned the shit up. Yo, who wants to bless this?
I said, number one seed flow. I'm always bringing heat. I seen this beat is full, so you know I had to eat. I'm back motivated. I done got my hunger back. Once the game in my grasp, y'all can't get it back. But try to take it, then clips might come your way. I'll assist you with your death, help you pass away. Let's box lyrically. Go 12 rounds. I come detox from Dr. Dre. I'll never drop, cause I can take a punch and give one right back. Mind fractured jaws, can you handle that? No, cause you grab guns, though you can't shoot well. Your gun game, Barack wife, Michelle. Say you gon' click and spark it, but what for? Yeah, you hit targets, the department stores. Cross ears to feet, no not heel to toe. Shells hit your feet, you dance, go ahead, heel toe. I appeal to the crowds that respect lyrics. You appeal to shit I don't condone and won't mention. Taking souls Indian style, when I spirit and in the end. You'll be around just as a spirit. Taking you on a ride, you better buckle up. I refuse to dumb it down, y'all better smarten up. Your heart's not up, so I'm a slave with you bitches. I'm on my Stevie J shit, I guess I own you bitches. I can't deny it, it's all in the fine print. Y'all jostling, y'all don't read before signing shit. See, that's part of love in hip-hop. To think about it, there is no love in hip-hop. That's why all the gimmicks seem to be leading shit. The game hates nerds, but respects lyricists. But me, I'm an lyricist who elevates with the bars. I keyboard at this in Mars, this them out of space bars. That's why when I'm in my space to craft, I'm a star that tracks on whatever's in this path. Try to put me on blast, then I'm a start gunning like a Blanche getting bust on. You won't see it coming.
Woo! Pete Bills! Damn. Yo, American Dream, what do you think about that?
Bit, but
fire.
American, what do you think about that?
Fire.
Wow.
I can't wait for the battle.
Yeah. That's a little preview for tonight, everybody. You know what I'm saying? Can't wait for that shit. Yo, that shit's gonna be dope. Scotty, what do you think about that?
I like cum jokes.
He's Vile. That's right up his alley. Yo, let me turn that beat up real quick. Let me get on this real quick. You know what I'm saying? Sir Spitz all day. You know what I'm saying? Album coming out whenever. You know what I'm saying? Coming through soon. Yeah. Yo. All day. Dojo. Yo. Yeah. Yo. If you heard of Sir Spitz, I murder words with the Sir the Perfect. Sturdy verses your vertebras get when you turn on my hits, which dirty your whip like a turd of bird shit. You want to go ham because you've been a hog since it's been a sin to skin the pig in the synagogue. Got a lot of gloom. Spot the chronic fume when I'm on a sonnet, sounded like a sonic boom. I'm ahead of my prime, ready to shine. Dead a competitor rhyme. Credit the editor, let him edit the time when he said it was better than mine. I'm a sentinel, sent to sentence you as soon as I sense the sentimental scent in you. Scriptures rip through lots of rappers like pistols, missiles, pit bulls, and velociraptors. Disciples try to describe the side of a rider, which is why I finally decided to decipher the cipher. Eyes wide on why yo coyotes when I creep up steep streets, three deep. We the roadrunners, beep, beep. Yeah, that's that reference for that ass. You want to keep going on this or you want to switch it up? What are we doing? Yeah, come on, American, let's do this shit.
Nah, man.
You rapping?
I don't write rhymes, I write checks.
Oh, shit, we got the businessman. Right. American Dream, he makes dreams happen.
I like checks.
Woo!
I'll take one of them.
Yo, I'm so amped for tonight. There's going to be crazy bars and shit. Oh, I think it's right up P. Bill's alley right there. I hear.
I'm going with this.
I can fuck with this.
It's like some party shit, man.
Well, we're gonna be turned out. What do you expect? Yo. The dojo, we fucking hold this shit down.
I said, these niggas talking out the ass and thinking that is fine. That's dumb like telling Mayweather, read between the lines. Y'all ain't hear my last song? I'm putting y'all in line. When I say give me mine, I'm steady on this grind to real rack rappers. Fucking up. Come on, let me get that back.
Yo, 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 come on, let's do the damn thing. Run that back, run that back. Just,
go ahead, go ahead.
Alright. Yo, this is like on some futuristic shit. Scotty, you want this? Or you just want to keep making that sound?
Huh?
Yo, we're going crazy right now, yo.
I think it's the beat. Change yeah.
Alright, alright. Next one, I'm just jumping. Oh, hell yeah, that was some fucking David Bowie shit. Yo, we're going crazy right now. Okay, I know Pete Bills wants this.
I'm going to let you set it off, dude. You go first.
Alright. Yeah. Sir Spitz in the building, yeah. Yo, 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 yo. Hit him with the wit and wisdom, lithalism. Now the kid is forbidden to spit riddance, so he didn't get acquitted, but he did get a bid in prison in a prism. Light refractions might distract him, like the plight of lifeless action. I'm so bright that I'm like flashing, blind the sight and slide right past him. Slipping plots like I'm dripping lots of dipping dots, tripping tots or sipping shots of different scotch. Whipping hot, skipping cops, spitting shit and getting tips from ripping spots. Gripping knots like the $1 million man, feeling ill from thrilling skill on demand. Chilling till I hit a billion on a grand. Still a villain if you steal upon his end. Shut your mouth, you hacking plaque of germs, but the punch is bout like a pack of derm. For acting firm, if you that concerned about getting blacked out, then pack a sack of sperm. I'm sick as hell like sickle cell. My nickel fell in the drinking well, it kicked a spell. My dick just swelled so quick to spit shit, it must fucking smell. I'm on my grind like Tony Hawk, I got no time for phony talk. I'm in my prime and from New York, too hot to trot like ponies walk, nigga. Yeah. Scotty, jump on it.
Yeah.
That's evil shit.
Yo, straight out the LW and YO. Guys know that my flow tasty like a gyro. I skip my pros, never end a day. My flow's the Lone Ranger, hi-ho, silver end away. Scotty Vile is the baddest cat rapping that cat in the hat, rat in the pack. Action pack, that's a fact. Half at that if you wanna get your teeth ground to a yellow powder, quick and nasty like a queef sound. I can be found with the illest click you heard of. Murder beats in the first degree once you heard the word of. Yeah. Mouth couch sitting, sipping on the click clack. Never lonely bitches, blow me homies, know I flip tracks.
Damn.
Upside down, over and then up again. Treat the beat like sneaky freak bitches when I'm humping them. Lumpy dump on them, nasty with the blah blah. Moderation nada, I just gotta yada yada.
Oh shit, Scotty Vile holding it down.
I'll bring it back one more time.
IP Bill's coming up.
Say, these niggas talking out the ass and thinking that is fine. That's dumb like telling Mayweather read between the lines. I ain't hear my last song, I'm putting y'all in line. I ain't trying to touch a neck when I say give me mine. I'm steady on this grind to kill rack rappers. Every time I spit, it's red rum backwards. That's murder, by the way. Just in case you don't know the drill, you're Superman at being a thief. Yeah, you're the man of steel.
Oh shit, the wordplay all day. Yo, Dojo fans, I know you could be expecting that shit tonight. You gotta come through to this shit, yo.
508 Nepperhand, ball for ball. Now
how much time we got? How much time we got? We got time for one more?
We got like 5 minutes.
Yo, Scotty, jump on this shit. Or yeah. Who wants to go on this shit? Let's switch it up one last time. Fucking Dojo fans, yo, you better be there tonight if you support real hip hop. We doing a movement right now. Yo, now it's turned up. Yo. We're about to blow past the time limit on this one. Let's do this shit. Yo, P Bills, we want more of that shit.
So, yo, lately I've been making all my bars meaner. So when my punches land, go to more than linear. Oh, that bitch, you got, I had that. You can keep her. Already wrestled her with my dude, my John Cena. Nigga, now I'm on to the next. Keeping my mind right, not trying to be stressed. Money on the brain, I'm wanting all the checks. So my pockets could be fatter than Precious neck. Speaking of Precious, my goons is like a if you're slipping, they'll rob you. Then run off with your chicken. And if your fam jump in, we'll hit your kindin. Lady fam jump in, then we'll hit your chicken. Nigga, y'all ain't up on my wordplay. I always come right, so you be left in the worst way. It's ass whooping season, I won't hesitate to slay. Anyone can get this work on any given day. Jab, hook, uppercut, coming in bunches. These lines hit on your B-day, they all birthday punches. Niggas will push you to a point to let a weapon fly. It's in my jeans to dump bodies and only leave eyes. I'm a top guy, should be in your top five. If you think otherwise, then your top get five.
Woo! Yo, that shit is hard body,
chicken.
Yo.
Chicken. And yo. Chicken.
Yo, and you know he's smart enough to not, you know, have that material that he's going to use tonight. So, you know what I'm saying? If that's what he's spinning right now, imagine what he's going on tonight. You know what I'm saying? That shit's going to be dope. He got something in store. I just know it. I know he's slick like that. Yeah.
I'll be chilling, but.
Yo, I like this shit, yo. Let me get this shit. Yo. It's royalty right there. Come on. American Dream, I need to be my hype man for this.
All
right,
go ahead.
Yeah.
Get that chicken.
That chicken.
It's all about that chicken.
Yo. I'm a real nigga. Yeah, yo, yeah, Cassidy. S-I-R,
Larceny, yes, I baby. Are
the best by far, better than the rest of y'all. S-P-I-T, rhymes be special mighty, especially when I specialize in IT.
Yeah.
Cause I'm it, tag a fag with the bomb spit like Saddam, but calm like Hans Blix. Keep up appearance, since I'm highest in vitamins and vitus in, then try to find the sky inside Leviathan.
Yeah.
He defeated pizza, please, or receded Peter bed. He defeated leaders like he needed to pee the bed. FML, FML, let him fail, let him fall, left him redder than a letter vendetta, then a door nailed to the cross. Tell the laws who the boss is. Force is the cause that I force in this office. No one knows the importance of coordinates. There are more than a smorgasbord of chords on an accordion.
Smorgasbord!
Yeah, bust chicken. Out your dictionary real quick.
Chicken on the smorgasbord.
Is that filet
buffet.
Chicken? Chicken filet over here.
Buffet style.
Yo. Yeah, Scotty, you want to jump on this? And then we'll fucking end out the show.
Is this a beat?
We got the chicken.
The chicken man.
Or yeah. Woo. You know, P-Bills, you want to take this and end out the show?
You want me to rap on this?
Yo, yeah, you got it. Yo, P-Bills.
That chicken, baby.
Yo, Dojo. This is what we expecting tonight. We amping the shit up.
Hey, I heard they had O's for sale.
Yeah. Get that chicken.
The chicken is right.
Drop yet.
P-Bills in the building.
Is this like this? This all is going? Fuck it, let me see.
This is the end.
Woo! Yeah, I say like this. My set. Yo, you're 5 times too cool. Man, I'm killing them. I ain't gotta be a leader for me to cap 10. No acting. I don't play the movie role. Only if I sold pills, then I play the movie role. It's Turkey Lady role. Once a year, I hit that. The fifth man out the year, I'm spinal with her. That's Maybach. Woo. Shots that I'm giving her. Look how I'm killing her. When headstone hard, I gotta rip her.
Yeah.
I go in and once labeled be believers, I be behind a circle of cheese like pizza with extra dough. And my crust stuff, I'm phoning in on fake shit. Calling all bluffs when your man's not tough. You're not about that gun shit in the state to not get the message. You don't know what text is.
Yo, Dojo. Yo, P-Bill's a body in the dojo right now. Preparation for tonight, you know what I'm saying? Bars for days, yo. Yo, son, yo.
I'm going to lose tonight. 3-0. I'm getting body back.
Yo, you said he thinks he's going to lose tonight. You know, we'll see what happens. We'll be out there.
I ain't sleeping on this kid, man. I think he's got some funny lines.
Yo, American Dream, final words.
What is battle? It's the American Dream, a.k.a. the Chicken Man. I'll be up in there tonight.
Yeah, American Dream's going to be popping.
Chicken.
Yeah, son, P-Bills all day. You know, we're going to be there with his man with it, hosting this shit tonight. This shit's going to be on fire, you know. All Yonkers, real hip-hop fans, I want you to be there to support the movement. That's how we doing it. And, you know, Sir Spitz, you know, Dojo, Scotty Vile, every day, Saturday, 3 p.m., fucking holding this shit down. Yo, American Dream, got anything to say before we get cut out of here?
Hey, it's... first time on the dojo. Was a pleasure. Y'all, you know, P-Bills, Scotty Vile, Sir Spitz, bless us with those rhymes.
Hell yeah.
Going to that battle tonight. I was talking about, actually, the second time you were on, I think, and you was talking about your battle. I called in and said I was going to be here during the
man of his word. He says what he means, and he means what he says.
That love.
Yeah.
See?
So I was like, all right, I'm going. It's our first battle, so. All
right, P-Bills, say what you want to say, and we out of here.
It's lit bar for bar 914 tonight. Going down 508 Nepperhand. Come through and watch me lose 3-0.
And what you got to say about that? Final word?
No, not really, man. Just show up, man.
Show up, show us love.
Bring the bars. I just tell everybody, bring the bars.
All right, yo, Dojo fans, you heard it first. If you're not there tonight, I don't know about your hip-hop knowledge, but, you know, it's questionable, yo. Yo, see us there. We're going to be supporting it. You know, check us out.
Is it BYOB or y'all going to have drinks there?
Bring your own bitches. Bring your own bars. Bring your own beers. Fuck it. We out of here.